this winter surge is kind of a wake-up call that this is like, this is bigger than we think. So, I mean, we're obviously both a little bummed out that we didn't get to go to the zoo and go to the other Smithsonian museums, but I kind of understand why, just because I've been like kind of tracking how COVID's been rising. So I kind of understand why they're starting to close things down, definitely.
Here we are at this moment again, where it makes sense again with the rising infection numbers to close. And that is hard, since we've certainly enjoyed several weeks of being reopened. We have new safety precautions and protocols. And so in many ways, the museums that closed in early March will not be the museums that reopen. We will have to be different in the way we operate. There's a good news piece of the story is we've all learned to be speak digital, speak video, do more distance learning. You have to remember there are 50 million kids, for the most part, are not going to school, and they're poor parents and really overworked teachers trying to provide materials. And the Smithsonian has rich curricula on all kinds of topics: history, science, culture, and the arts. And we've been seeing all kinds of folks utilize these. Again, the Smithsonian museums are free. However, other museums rely very heavily on ticket revenue, let alone store revenue and other areas to support their operations. And so you're seeing from the American Alliance of Museums that there's really significant loss on a monthly basis. We're hoping that when there is yet another stimulus package, that museums are also included. It really has been an incredibly difficult time, and we are well aware that not every museum will reopen. That's just going to be the reality of things. What the future holds, it is worrisome. It is worrisome. But we will be back. We will be ready to reopen our doors when it is determined it will be safe again.